Okay. So you have gone through the homework that I had sent?
Adam
Yes. Okay. So first we will go through your homework that you had written before from the previous class. Did you write your own sentences?
Adam
Okay. How many have you written?
ಒಂದು ಐದು ಬರ್ದಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಮೇಡಮ್.
Okay. Can you try to answer these questions in English?
ಹಾಂ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
Yeah. How many have you written sentences?
ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ 5 sentences.
Okay. Five sentences of your own.
ಹೌದು ಮೇಡಮ್.
Yes. See those words or those answers also you can give in English. Okay.
ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್.
Okay, from now onwards, just even if it takes little extra time, half a minute more to answer, it is okay. But see that you try most of the answers to, give in English, okay?
ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್.
Okay, so can you read the first sentence?
ಏ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೈಡ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಕೌಸ್ ರೋಪ್.
Repeat, repeat.
ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ tied up the cow's rope.
Cow's rope. Okay. What do you mean by cow's rope?
Asudu
Okay. You mean you have tied the cow with a rope?
agga.
Yeah. So, tied the cow's rope means cow is there or not? It is not. The sentence does not say.
Sorry, madam.
You have tied the rope, but we don't know whether the cow is there the other side or not, right? So you should say, I have tied the cow with its rope. Its rope is even more specific. Okay.
Sorry, madam.
Okay. Next one.
I ate my breakfast with my grandmother.
Okay.
I have to visit my friend's home.
Ah.
My father said to me to do that work.
Okay.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು IML ಮಾಡಕ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್,
ಹಾ
ಐ ಆಮ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೀನಟ್ಸ್.
ಓಕೆ ದ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಹೌಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್
ಸರಿ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್
ಸರಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್.
ಹಾ ಸೊ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಯು ಮೇಕ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಯು ವಿತ್ ದ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಪೇಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ 11 ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ಯು ಅ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್
ಸರಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಬಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಲೊಕೇಶನ್ ಓಕೆ
ಸರಿ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ಸೊ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಫರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅ ನಾನ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಲೊಕೇಶನ್ ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಅ ಡಯೆಟ್
ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್.
Diet does not mean a place, but you are on a program. Okay, you are on a reading program, right? This one is on the phone that you are engaged in. I am on a reading program shows that you are doing something, but physically you are not tied up to some place. Okay, but if you say I am in living room. Or I am in study room to do the reading program that shows that you are physically somewhere. The sentence shows that your location is there in that. Okay?
Sorry, madam.
Okay, that is the difference between I am in and I am on. Okay, so
Okay.
we will go through some of the examples from last class. I am in school. If you see the page number 11, it says I am in the shower. I am in the lobby. I'm in a car. I am in a house, I am in a school.
Sorry, ma'am.
And I am on, for that they have given two examples. I am on the phone, I am on my computer, or I am on the web, or I am on internet, something like that. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So see if you can make one sentence for I am in. Can you do that right now?
Yes, madam.
Yeah. Try.
I am in a restaurant.
Yeah, very good.
I am in my home.
Yeah.
I am in my college to do my second PU admission.
Very good. Okay. See, you tried with just that instant only you are able to make three sentences. Good. Very good. And see if you can make one more one sentence at least with I am on.
I am on road.
Huh?
I am on road.
Road is again a physical location, right?
Very good. Yeah. I am on WhatsApp.
Yeah, that is good.
Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. So you tried your best, and let us give some more time. By tomorrow, next class, see if you can make two more sentences using I am on. Okay. And the homework also says that you should make five sentences using the words from the videos. I know that the videos are having conversations between people. The first video, which talks about the episode, the second episode, I think, you have to catch some words from their conversation, and you have to look for the meanings and make sentences of that. And the second video talks about a person who is giving a speech in TED, right? TED Talk. Did you see that video? Can you answer that in English?
I can't able to see those videos.
So both the videos you did not see?
First one nodde madam, the serial then.
Okay. So second one is a person giving a speech in the TED Talk platform. It is only about 15 to 16 minutes. I see if you get to see those things and try to observe their their sentences and see what type of words they're using, it will be very, very helpful, because you will get exposure to different words which you have not heard before. You can search those meanings in the dictionary and see how you can make sentences for those. Because the now that you are doing good in these classes, the homeworks are given for that reason, right? So you can improve even on a faster pace. Okay. So please see that next time, today onwards when I'm sending. Before going to bed, you can see. I will send it to you today itself, the videos, okay?
Sorry, madam.
The other questions and other things that you have to do, you can do later. At least watching part, you finish it off today itself. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Now we'll move on to today's session. It is about framing questions.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you start with the heading and start reading?
Key vocabulary and phrases.
Yes.
What's your name?
Okay.
Where do you live? What do you do? How about you? Practice conversations.
Okay.
Personal questions. Strangers meeting in a party and exchanging personal information. Raghav, what's your name? Sham, I am Sham. Raghav, hi Sham, I am Raghav. Where do you live? Sham, I live in HSR Layout. Where do you live? Raghav, I'm in Jayanagar. What do you do, Sham? Sham, I work in Infosys. Raghav, how about you? Sham, I work in ICICI Bank. Raghav, great party, isn't it? Sham, yes, I am loving it.
Okay, good. The sentences you were able to read, fairly good. But one word I want you to pay attention. Where do you live? It is not where do you live. Okay? Live, that I that you say should not be long. Don't drag live. You should cut it and make it a short word. Can you repeat after me? Where do you live?
Where do you live?
Yeah. Can you read the answer now?
I live in Jayanagar.
Okay. See, now there is that way you pronounce it right this time. Okay. All other words were fine. And in this page, before we go on to the next page, this there is one contraction in the first
what
question. Yeah. Did we write this before in yesterday's class? No, right? Chen. Did you, what's, what is made into what's. Okay. You have to write it down so that we don't miss it out. After you finish writing, we will move on to page number
13.
Okay, go start with the next example.
General questions between friends.
Ah.
Jatina Jatina madam adu sir.
Jatin.
Jatin. Where did you go last night? Lalit. We went to a restaurant. Jatin. Which one? Lalit. We went to a canopy restaurant.
Read the sentence where Lalit is giving the answer.
We went to canopy restaurant.
Yeah, went to a is not there, a is not there. So please pay attention while reading. Okay, yeah, continue.
Jatin, how was the food there? Lalit, it was good and tasty. Jatin, do you get vegetarian food there? Lalit, yes. There are a lot of vegetarian dishes. Jatin, is too expensive to eat there? Lalit, not really.
Okay. Can you read the repeat the Jatin's question, last one?
Is it too expensive to eat there?
Yeah. So that is it too. You have to give little gap between the those three words. Is it too expensive to eat there? Okay. But otherwise, you did very good. Okay. Yeah. Now, the third one, third example.
General questions using like. Rohit, what do you like to do in your spare time? Ritu, I like to spend time with my friends. Rohit, where do you all like to meet? Ritu, we all like to meet in the neighborhood park. Rohit, what do you all like to do? Ritu, we all like to sit and chat and go for a coffee later. Rohit, where do you all like to go for the coffee? Ritu, there is a small restaurant near the park that serves very good coffee.
Okay, very good. You read it properly. Now we will go on to the reading comprehension.